We have completed 7 chapters now. Today we are going to the next chapter, 8th chapter, that is basic geometrical concepts. Okay. Now open page number 111, children. Page number 111. Here, observe this picture. What is this picture, children? What do you observe here? This picture? It is all over green field is there, one house is there, tree is there, and this is, what is the middle part of this? It is a road, okay. So, observe the aerial view of the path leading to village from A to B and from B to C. Observe here, A to B and B to C. From A to B, it is a straight, whereas from B to C, it is not straight, but curved. From A to B, it is a straight line, okay. From B to C, it is a curved. It is a curved line. The line with end point A and B is called a line segment. And from B to C, it is a curved line. So, we are seeing from line A to B. What do you call this one? It is a line segment. Okay. Here, 2 points is there. No, line segment means what, children? It has 2 end points. Okay, so A, B is a line segment. From B to C, it is a curved line. It is not a straight, it is a curved line. Okay. So, how many end points are there in the line segment A, B? What, ma'am? So, how many end points are there in the line segment A, B? So, in the line segment AB, how many endpoints are there? 2 endpoints. One endpoint is A and another endpoint is on B. So, how many endpoints here? 2 endpoints. Next, do you know how to play carrom board? Do you know how to play carrom board? You already know now how to play carrom board. So, 2 players are playing it. There are 5 points left on the board. Here, 2 players are playing the carrom board. In the carrom board, how many coins are left? 5 coins are left. So, coins are shown in the figure. Here, how many are coins? See here. A, B, C, D, E. So, 5 coins is there. Players P and Q are playing. Here, player P, here, player Q are sitting here, opposite sides, they are playing. So, now it is the turn of player P. It is the turn of player P. So, it is a, what is this? It is a striker. So, how many rays are there? How many rays are there here in this carrom board? Can you find it? What are the rays? Did you know what is one ray? Ray has one end point. Okay, ray has only one end point. So, what are the rays here? How many rays are there here? See here, this is a ray. What now? I think you are having problem, material problem. Here it is clear. Okay, check it here. It is ray. Here it is also a ray. It is also a ray. So, ray has one end point and another side it will be arrow mark is there. That is called a ray. So, how many rays are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many rays are there here? 4 rays. Okay, right here 4. How many coins are close to the player Q? So, how many coins are close to player Q? Here, player Q is there. How many coins are close to player Q? 1, 2. How many coins are there? 2 coins. While striking with striker, there is a possibility of a coin touching with any other. Draw all such possibilities in the given picture by means of the line segments. So, by striking a striker, it will touch any coin or not. Here striker is there. If you touch like this, it will touch this coin, B coin now. Like that, any possibilities is there, you have to draw the line segments. Okay. How many such line segments can be drawn in the picture? How many such line segments can you draw? It will be B. And here E. And okay, D and E only. And C also. So, 3 line segments will come. Next, observe this table. Turn the page over to observe this table. See here. Figure C. Point A. What do you call this one? One dot is there and put the letter capital A. So if you denote any point, you have to denote that letter capital letters only. Don't use small letters. You have to denote the point with capital letters only. So here point is there and here denotes it capital letter A. So capital letters and the A, B, C you have to take it. What do you call this one? Point A. What do you call this point? A. Point A. See here, point A. And next one, see notation given. Point is given and B. So how to read as point B. Very good. Point B. Point B. Here you have to write blank is given. Now you have to write point B. Surya, right? Point B. Point B. And next to see, A, B is given here. Okay, notation. What is the notation? A, B. So what is here? One end point is there, and the one is arrow mark is given here. So what do you read as? How to read as? Ray A B. Ray A B. So here dash is given and read as ray X Y. So what is the notation you have to write here? What is the notation you have to write here? X Y. Ray symbol. You have to like this. Okay, ray X Y. Write that one. Ray X Y. Next, see here figure A, B. Notation A, B. Next, read as segment A, B. What do you call? Segment A, B. And here dash is given, read as segment O, B. Segment O, P. So, how to write notation? O, P segment. O, P. Segment means it has two end points. So, you have to draw the line. Okay, OP. Next, line here, two arrows is there. Two arrows is there means what you call this one? Line. Okay, so line has two arrows is there. No end points is there for line. Okay, and ray has one end point and line segment has two endpoints is there. Okay. So what do you call this thing? Line AB. Here one line is given. There is no name. So you have to write line. Line. Write line. You can denote line as small letters. Okay. You have to write any small letters. Not use capital letters. Next in the exercise 8.1, in the given figure there are some points marked, name them. Here some points are marked here. See here some points are marked here. You have to name the points. Name the points. Okay. So what do you letter you have to use? You have to use only capital letters only. So as you like any letter you have to take. Okay. Suppose here like this point is given. Okay, you have to take any capital letters as you like. This is P, Q, R, S, P, U. Any as you like, any capital letters you have to use it. Okay, right. In the textbook only write mark. Join the points given below. Name the line segments so formed in the figure. So we have point A given, point B, point D, point C given. You have to join that point and write the name of the line segments. I drop join like this. Okay, in your textbook only you have to join it. What are the line segments? You have to name it. AB, AB, DC, CD, BA. Right here only in the textbook. Okay, and next AC. What more? Next one, second one. What is given here? One circle is given here. Like this. This is point A, point B, point C, point D, point E, point F. Okay. So you have to join the points, name the line segments. You have to write the line segments. What are the line segments? See here. I join like this. AC. AC. And AD. Next, AE, AF. Can you join AB? Yes, AB. Okay, AC, AD, AE, AF, AB. Next, CF, BC. BC. BD, BE, BF, BA. Already we drawn now, so you don't write BA. Okay. Another one. Next, C and CD, CD, CE. CA already drawn, so you don't write. Okay, CA or A, CA, it is the same. Okay, next. What is the next one? DE. DE. BF. DF. Next. DA already we draw. Next. DB already we draw. DC already we draw. So don't write. And next one. Identify the following from the given figure. So we have one picture is given here. And here the points are given. This is B. This is J. This is I. This is A. And this is F. This is E. This is G. This is H. Sorry, this is D. And this is H. This is C. Okay? So the picture is given like this. You have to identify the following from the given figure. Any 6 points. First one. Any 6 points. You have to write any 6 points. That means here points is given now. You have to write any 6 points. Suppose I write here A, point A. Point A, point B, point C, point D, point E, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, point F. Okay, 6 points. Give it up. Right here. The next book only you have to write it here. First question. Okay, first answer write it here. Beside of the first question.
Next, what is the second question? Any 6 line segments. Any 6 line segments you have to write starts with G. You have to start with G. You have to write any 6 line segments. So where is G here? Here. So you have to write line segments. Line segment means it has 2 end points. Okay. So first one is GH. Right here. GH. And put the symbol like this. Okay. Line, draw the line here. Next. GD. GD. And next. GE. GE. Okay. 1, 2, 3 over. Next. GF. G, F, next, another one, G, A, G, A, G, A, next, G, C, G, C, completed 6 line segments, with starting with G, G, H, G, D, G, E, G, F, G, A, G, C. Next, third one is any 6 rays with initial point I. So, with initial point I, you have to write any 6 rays. 6 rays means it has 1 point only, another one, another side it will be arrow mark. Okay. So, 6 rays you have to write from I. So, I, B, I, B, I, B. How to put the symbol for ray? Like this. Okay. I, B. Next. I, D, I, D, put the symbol compulsory, I, D, and next, I, C, I, C, next, I, A, I, A, and next, I, B, I, C, I, A, over. And ID also over. Remaining? How many write? 6 rays. Okay. So, where you have to write I, J, I, Z. I, J. Next one. I, H. I, H. Completed 6? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Right. Next one, fourth one is any three lines. You have to write any three lines. Lines means it has no end points. Both are having arrows. It will be extended both sides. So any three lines. What you have to write any three lines means E C. E C. So you have to write the symbol like this. E C. Next B D. B D. And next A D. A D. You have to put the simple lines. Okay. Any three of the three lines. Now see the fourth one. Write true or false. A line has two end points. A line has two end points or not, children? Line has two end points. What is the line symbol? This is the line symbol. It has two end points. No. Okay. So, line has no end points. It has, but it is given two end points. It is true or false? False. Write here false. First one, write false. First one is false. Next, ray is a part of a line. Ray is a part of a line or not? Yes, ray is a part of a line. It is true. Third one, a line segment has two end points. A line segment has two end points or not? Yes, it is true. It has two end points. Fourth one, we can draw many lines through two points. So, we can draw many lines through two points. Okay, it is right or wrong? Can we draw from two points more lines? We have to draw only one line only. Okay, so it is false. Now what you have to write is, what is the homework is up to here, up to four completed, no, four questions you have to write in the CW. In the CW you have to put the heading chapter 8, basic geometric concepts. You have to put the heading, and next put the heading exercise 8.1. write from here first question. Already wrote in the textbook, no? So you have to write in the CW also. Okay, this is the homework for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 4 questions you have to write in the CW. That is the homework for you. And tomorrow all of you bring your scales, ruler. Okay, ruler means nothing but scale and divider. Did you know divider, children? Did you know compass or divider? Like this is the divider. Okay, did you have? All of you bring this one for tomorrow class. Tomorrow bring scales and divider. Okay, children? So, what is the homework today? You have to write up to 4 sums in CW. Okay, children? Goodbye. We'll continue tomorrow. Bye.